the world's first mind-controlling headsets. That was actually quite good, I know. The world's first mind-controlling headsets. We jump all the way through to the dark. The disturbing. Lie detecting. Robotic. Monkey. We're not quite sure what to say about monkey. So before we go anything, we need to start with minds. If we're going to do anything with minds, we need to start with the most important minds in the room. And they are, of course, your minds. And they're going to take us on a journey. And to do that, I want us to use possibly the world's greatest technological innovation from the very banks of the River Nile, the first papyrus, all the way to today, and bring you the paper plane. Sir, you're not looking very impressed. This just isn't any paper plane. This is the paper plane of destiny. Do you know why it's called the paper plane of destiny? No, because it knew you'd say that. Now do you know why it's called the paper plane of destiny?
No.
Okay, still knew you'd say that. I'm going to throw the paper plane of destiny amongst you. I want you to catch the paper plane of destiny. The paper plane of destiny does have a very sharp point, so please don't catch it in your eye. Good, okay, you ready?
Yes.
That's feeble. Are you ready?
Yes!
Paper plane of destiny, it's coming in, here we go. Oh, I've just killed a child. You stood up, life would be so much better. What's your name? Yasmin, give me a favour. We're going to start on this journey. To go on our journey, we're going to need to have some sustenance. So we need to name a food, a vegetable. First vegetable that comes to your head, go.
Broccoli.
I'm sorry?
Broccoli.
Broccoli, amazing, good. Okay, so you have some broccoli, fantastic. First vegetable, very healthy one, good job. Take the paper plane, destiny, throw it to someone else. Very, very quick, throw it to someone else. Good, okay, stand up, sir, stand up. You don't get around the door. Thank you for coming. The audience in the world. Sir, on our journey, we're going to need a mode of transport. It could be anything from a tricycle all the way through to a UFO. Main mode of transport, shout it out to everyone who can hear now.
Train.
A train, lovely, very good. We'll walk you in the train, beautiful, good. Obviously, a train fan in the back. Take the paper plane of destiny. The paper plane of destiny, one last time, to someone else. 3, 2, 1, go! I'd like you to, when you know this, we're going to think about this, you might need a bit of help. I just want you to relate me pi to 25 decimal places. Matt, could you do me a favor? We're going to need a friend. We need a friend to go with us on our journey. And our friend, I want us to think of someone in here, someone very famous, someone you think everybody would know. So just something that maybe a TV thing you've seen, or someone you think everyone would know, not your mum. Although she's very lovely. Good. Can you think of someone to say?
Gordon.
Gordon, very good. Someone like a character, someone in here that we think everyone would know. So maybe someone from a film or someone famous.
Jerry.
Is it Tom and Jerry?
Yeah.
Very good. We're just going to write that down. That's good. You can take a seat for me if you want, if you would like, yeah? Now we're going to take this and I'm in fact going to ask someone, put this down for a second. Many thanks to IKEA. For the sponsorship, they say theft. Could you give me the best impression you can of a crowd? Actually, you might need a pad in there. Give me the best impression of a crowd asking questions at school. It goes like this. Yes, very good. Higher, perfect. Just hold that. Good, just stay there. Hold it. So at this stage, we have to think of something. It's a little bit strange, though. I've asked you to go on a journey, and a lot of things have been said, including Gordon, which I won't, but I did throw me. However, before we even started today, I did have a bit of a thing. You've got to think to yourself. Look around the room for a second. Look at the type of people who are here. You might have been able to guess at some of the type of people who are here, perhaps. And you might start to think about what would be in their mind. Come here, guys, grab a seat, grab a seat. What would be in their mind? Had just gone flush gone off the day. It's not a country can go on through quick. Let's give a round of applause. So, now, what would be in your mind? Had just gone flush gone on a busy high day. What are the types of things you're going to be thinking? Who are you going to be thinking of? And I did have to think about it. And I wrote a few things down. Now, also, I sealed the envelope and I asked someone to watch me do this and to sign it. Philip, is that your signature on this sealed envelope?
That's my signature.
Philip's signed across the seal of this envelope. And I want to open it up so that everyone sees us break the seal for the first chance to sign this out. And let's ask someone to read that voice, Philip. It's going to be you would. Do me a favour.
Yeah.
Take that out for a second. The handwriting is awful. Now, sir, pass me this paper, good. Now, very strange thing. Earlier today, guys, I asked you to think of three things as a group of people. These three things, no one could have predicted. Three random people choosing three random things, and you chose three different things. However, I put something, I put it in an envelope. The first thing, by the way, you chose as a vegetable was broccoli. The second thing you chose was a train, and the third thing you chose was Jerry from Tom and Jerry, I believe. Philip, what are the things that I wrote down?
Broccoli. Train. Tom.
If you look at the science behind this thing, it's something which is basically, it's called choice architecture. For those of you who are interested, it's a subset of behavioral economics, actually came before that. It's something which controls how you choose. A couple of things. It's the same reason why supermarkets put their own branded products at eye level. And it's the same reason why if you've got children and it comes to dessert time and they ask for dessert, you might say, great, would you like an apple or some yogurt? Because if you go one step further and say, what would you like? They'll say, all the chocolate cake I can eat. It's the way that we structure choices. Now, I got quite interested in this as a mind reader. And I worked for a year with neuroscientists at the University of Bristol and their technology department, would have come here if they didn't answer the emails, don't know why. To develop what I think is the world's first mind-controlling headset. How is it possible to do this but using technology? And I don't bring them out very often, but I've brought them here today because I want to try a demonstration with you live today to see if we can make this work. Are you up for this?
Yes!
Okay, no promises, they are very flaky, they're worth about 42 grand. Please don't steal them, okay? Now, they don't always work, but we're going to try it. I need it. We're going to need someone to help me with this. I need someone. The problem is, for legal reasons, and my insurance, they need to be over 60. That's the only sort of bad thing. But yes, you might work, actually. Come on down, Mr. Let's give a round of applause. As you make Now, Connor, what we have here, this is the first one. Ignore the fact that there's an artery on it, doesn't count. Good, and we're going to try to turn this on you, okay? So, I know they look a little bit weird, but that's kind of the idea. So, what we have here is basically the system that we're dealing with. You can go and look this up if you really want to. August 2013, the first example ever, mind-to-mind control. University of Washington. Genuinely happened. They basically, one person sitting in one room watching space invaders, wearing a brain scanning set. He thought, fire, trigger fire. They took that brainwave pattern, going to the University of Washington in 2014 August, transferred it to an individual in another room wearing a headset which stimulated his brain in the same thought. This man thought, fire, this man involuntarily moved his finger. This, don't look up the study. We were very interested to see if we could replicate that. We couldn't quite replicate that, because we're not funded by the United States military. But we've got pretty close. What we have here is basically, this controls lateral movement. So this affects the lateral movement. So we're just going to turn it on. Okay. start to see, yeah, okay, you can see this tuning in. I know the hit space isn't the biggest thing in the world. It's flashing red, that means it's trying to get a signal, and hopefully your face will be yellow. That's good, just breathe in for me, you don't need to do much. Just breathe in and relax, genuinely relax. Okay, you can see it's got better red because he's laughing. And try and stay focused for me, just focus, breathe in, breathe out. There, it's starting to take, it's starting to work, okay? Breathe in again, breathe out. Can you see the green light? Good, so the green light, okay, so we've got a basic reading going on here. So it doesn't always work completely. I've got a sending headset, yeah? This means that what I've got runs through the box, there's a lot of software there, goes through and basically it just kind of stimulates what we call the lateral movement centers of the brain. You won't feel it unconsciously, yeah? But you will have something of a gut feeling, yeah? It's different for different people. Some people, they actually, it's not a conscious thing. Some people, it's like a kind of, I just think it's that. But it will affect you somehow. Now, you're starting to look a little bit nervous. I want to reassure you that I take health and safety very seriously. Your safety is at the heart of my body. So, just to be sure about that. Well, I don't know about you, but I feel a lot better. It's funny, you know, the reason we haven't published any research on this is if you want to do it at the university, you've got to go through all sorts of ethics committees and stuff. You're on stage, no one cares. I'm going to take this off because I can't see a little bit here. So these are more tuning, so don't worry about them too much. So the idea is I'm going to think, now we need to calibrate first of all, we need to ascertain if this is something that we're going to be able to breathe. And so I'm going to try and send a really basic thing to you, yeah? It's just going to be left and right. And so I want you to, it's quite hard to begin with, but you're just going to try and see if you can get a sense of what it is, okay? Right. Well, possibly left. Breathe in for me. I'm going to write down what we're going to go for. Okay. Breathe in for a second. Okay, I'm going to start sending it to you now. You will get a sense of left and right. Whichever one you get, I want you to hold that hand up. Should take about 2 or 3 seconds to get. If you're not sure, just guess, yeah? You're getting more of it right?
Yeah.
Weird, right? So I said I'd write something down. What am I writing down?
You wrote half of it, yeah.
Statisticians among you will know that's a 1 in 2. We're going to go through it now. Okay, you're starting to get into it. It's not like a distinct sort of conscious thing, but it's kind of weird, okay? Same thing, okay? This time, okay. Did you see what I wrote? Good, okay. Same go. Get a feeling, sending it to you. 3, 2, 1, go. Right, same feeling, right? Okay. Was that right, Taylor?
Yeah,
right.
It's
1 in 4. So focusing on this is the weird thing about it. It just stimulates a kind of rough sense. So I was thinking, what would we do with ourselves with the world's first mind-controlling headset? And I thought what we'd invent is the world's first mind-controlling sat-nav. And I wanted to see if we can have a little chance to explore this today. Yeah? Give me a favour, just take a step forward to me. And we're going to go on a bit of an imaginary journey. I'm going to control your left and right as we go. Now, I'm going to take you on a journey. Before we start, I have packed for our destination. Just hold on to that for me. Okay? Just hold on to it. Don't do anything without our destination. I'm going to try and take us on a driving journey to see if we can get the destination that I'm hoping we're going to reach. Obviously, we can't get in a car to do this. Well, we could do it, but it'd be very boring for the rest of you. So I'm going to kind of use these. It's like, I want you to imagine we're coming to crossroads, and I'll kind of be holding up left and right, and I'll send you a left and right. Yeah? And you just go with what your feeling is. And if you chose left, you go left, and we keep cycling through. Okay? So let's get in our cars. Okay, keep my mind on the board first. Okay, sit down. Good. Now you can just start the engine. No, yeah. Good man. Okay, good. Good. What about the seatbelt? Good. Okay, good. Let's go. Yeah, and he's got the radio on in the car, which I think is a nice thing as well. Good. Okay, we're going to start juggling off. I'm going to start sending you a direction. I'm going to send you left or right. I want you to shout whatever you're getting. 3, 2, 1, go.
Left.
Left. Very good. Good, keep going with me. Left. Okay, moving on. Okay, we're going to keep driving. Drive a little bit faster now. Imagine the car, right? You keep driving. Maybe turn the radio on. Yeah, nice. What we got? Oh, a bit of Chris Rea, Lady in
red.
Nice. Good, okay, good. Good. And keep going. Okay, I'm getting from left and right. Where are you going?
Left.
Are you sure? Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Good, okay, keep going. Keep driving. Child! Okay, good. Now we're going. Like I'm thinking, so you've really got to try and see if it's left or right. Genuinely trying to take a breath. Breathe in. Okay, left or right?
Right.
Good. Yeah, just keep going. Left or right?
Right.
And just turn around and cross. Okay, now this is the destination, yeah? We're going to pull this out for a second. Would you just hold that, please, sir, yeah? Just hold it like that. I don't want anyone to touch it. Now, there's a whole bunch of destinations. Hold those. Just grab a tab. So you could have, with the destination, I could have sent you somewhere. So one destination you could have gone to,
Skegness.
Lucky. Or
Barbados.
Tap tap. Another destination we could have gone to, Blackpool. Sure. No, you like that one, don't you, man? Very nice. Yeah, good. Or
Ibiza.
But you didn't. We took a series of different decisions, left and right. If you noticed, we were moving left and right the whole time. This is the destination. I just want you to hold that to your chest for a second. That I control the movement you were doing as you got there. You could have made any number of turns. Now, just so you're aware, I told you I packed for the destination I wanted to take you to. I packed a space blanket. I packed some space ice cream. And I packed... You could have had any of those destinations, but I controlled your movement the whole time through. You had this feeling. What's the destination I want to take us to?
To infinity and beyond.
Now these are big movements. We're going to try one more test because it's going so well. Normally I wouldn't do this. These are big movements we've been doing. If you want this to get this to work, and this is what we spent hours calibrating. You have to get very precise movements. And that's what we're going to try right now. Take a step, couple of steps over there, nice and easy, with this beautiful table. You good? Now we've got some cards, because it wouldn't be a very good condition unless I could do something with cards. You can see all the faces?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there we go. So this is the precise, this is when it gets hard. Now if this goes wrong, you can boo me. If it goes right, you have to go crazy. Is that a deal?
Okay.
Is that a deal? Someone wants a deal or no deal over there. I like it. Good. So, at this point, I'm going to ask you to put your hand, your finger over the middle. I'm going to be sending you left with my very small. I'm not going to say anything. When you feel comfortable, you're ready to stop. Say I'm ready. Yeah? Because I don't want people to think I'm trying to cue you with my mouth or anything like this, okay? So I'm going to send you out to go with this, okay? I'm going to try and send you left and right. We'll be a few seconds, you know? And I want you to just get the feeling of whether you want to move left and right, okay? So I'm the same thing. Put your finger down on the part that we're stopping on. You comfortable there? That's where you felt you wanted to stop. Just to be clear, they're all positive hidden. And you comfortable 9 positive?
9 diamonds.
Oh, so everyone can see. It's comfortable 9 diamonds. Now it's weird, right? You've got your hand moving quite fast at work. Now, what's kind of weird is I've got another deck of cards here. You just need to be the eyes of the audience. 9 of diamonds is the card. There's 9 of hearts, 9 of clubs, 9 of diamonds there. And just check that is the only 9 in the deck, so everyone's comfortable, yeah?
Yep.
Okay, take this out for a second. Now, the weird thing is that if you stopped on the queen, spades on the back, says boo. Two of hearts says boo. Ten of clubs says boo. In fact, on the back of every single one of these cards, it says boo, 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 on the back of every single one of these cards, except for one card. One single card. Turn over the nine of diamonds. You could have stopped on any of those. Turn it over with a big, loud voice. What is this down the back?
Go crazy!
Yeah! This